This is a production of PBS 39.
Good evening. Thanks so much for joining us. I'm Amy Burkett. About 16,000 students in Pennsylvania get a public education without actually going to school. They attend one of the 11 cyber charter schools across the state. While they represent less than 1% of students in the Commonwealth, funding for their education has caused a controversy in Harrisburg. Laura Mchugh explores one virtual charter school and how a new measure in the State House of Representatives would change its funding.
2, 4, 6, 8, 10, 12.
In this Allentown home, school days begin like in any other house.
I wake up, get dressed, I eat breakfast.
But when most kids head to the bus stop, 9-year-old Maggie and her 7-year-old brother Paul head to their dining room.
I just stay home all day and do schoolwork and finish it up as fast as I can.
They'll spend the next 6 hours studying history, math, science, art, music, and language arts.
So when we diagram a sentence, what's the first thing we're going to do?
Mom Christy Shive acts as a tutor, or as she calls it, the kids' academic coach. But she's not their teacher, and Paul and Maggie aren't homeschooled. They're two of hundreds of students in Lehigh and Northampton counties who go to a cyber charter school.
If there's an interest or a subject that they're really interested in, we can expand on it. We can go to the library and find more books about it, or maybe take a field trip that will apply to something that we've read or studied.
Neither Maggie nor Paul have ever attended a traditional brick-and-mortar school, but they live in the East Penn School District.
When you plot the points on the computer, it'll actually draw a line and connect the points if it was correct.
That means East Penn has to pay the cyber charter school about 75% of the $8,500 they spend on other students in the district. This model, in which the money follows the student, is the same throughout the state. East Penn School Board member Chuck Ballard says it's not fair that some school districts pay more than others for the same service.
Depending on what school district you're in, the payment can vary wildly all over the state, from $7,000 like East Penn to maybe $10,000 or $11,000 in some of the more affluent school districts. So there's no uniform standard of payment, and it's not based on the cost of cyber instruction.
That's why Ballard and the Pennsylvania School Board Association support House Bill 446, the Cyber Charter School Accountability Act, proposed by State Representative Karen Beyer.
Since each school district in the state pays a different amount to send one of their students to a cyber charter school, Representative Beyer's bill creates a flat rate that each charter school will receive for a student no matter where they're from.
It makes sense because the delivery of education for these kids is the same.
Representative Beyer says she created this proposal to bring equity and accountability to a relatively new option in education. She stresses it's not a criticism on any parent's choice to use a cyber charter school.
They can do that, but what I'm concerned about is whether or not taxpayer dollars are being appropriately spent.
Her proposal would establish a statewide tuition rate based on how much the most efficient and effective cyber charter school spends on each student. It would also restrict fund balances and address attendance hours, truancy, and late payments from local districts.
All cyber charter schools should understand that they're part of the public school mix, that they're 100% funded by the taxpayer. And as a result of that, they've got to be accountable the same way.
The flat tuition rate works out to about $7,000 a student. But the CEO of Maggie and Paul School says they spend on average $8,000 per student each year. She says the change would penalize students whose districts pay more than $7,000 under the current plan.
We would be looking at, as any district would look at, you know, where do we cut in order to meet that? And in the end, the students would suffer.
While it doesn't have buses or buildings, Dr. Joanne Jones-Barnett reports the Pennsylvania Virtual Charter School has a different kind of infrastructure. They supply each student with a computer, printer, and internet connection in addition to their textbooks and other materials. What she says they don't have is the ability to create more funding by raising taxes.
So we don't have any other way to generate revenue. What we have is what we have.
Since the virtual charter school opened in September 2001, Barnett says they've worked hard to dispel stereotypes about cyber schools and their students. She says students don't just hide behind the computer. They interact with their parents in person and their teachers online.
Maybe. What do the rest of you guys think?
High school history teacher Andrew Neft says the cyber charter school is just like a normal classroom, except his students wear their pajamas.
That's really the only difference. It's a real-time class. We have class discussions like you would have in normal classes. Students, when they have a question, they push a button that raises their hand.
Back in the Shives classroom, PJs aren't allowed, but family time is cherished.
If they were in school, I wouldn't see them all day long. And so it really helps build our family unit. And it's fun. I love it. I love to be with my kids. I would miss them if they were in school.
No one here wants to take that choice away, but some believe it needs more oversight. For Tempo, I'm Lauren Mchugh reporting.
Support for Tempo is provided by
building a workforce system called PA Career Link Lehigh Valley. Training the workforce to meet employer hiring needs. Connecting employers with workers. And workers with jobs. Lehigh Valley Workforce Investment Board.
RCN and RCN4, partnering with PBS 39 and committed to bringing quality local television programming to the residents of the Lehigh Valley. RCN, cable, phone, and internet.
And by the members of PBS 39. Thank you.